Hi guys, welcome to my first YouTube video. For my first makeup tutorial, I wanted to create a look that was all about the eyes. If you want to know how to recreate this look, then keep on watching. Alright guys, so the first product I'll be using is Max Fix Plus. The scent is lavender. This was limited edition, but this product is going to hydrate and refresh her skin, giving her an instant boost of freshness. So what I want to do now is I want to use the Max 2-in-1 serum. I'm going to be applying this product with my hands, and this is going to create more of a smoother, softer canvas for any product that I decide to put on next, okay? As the skin is soaking that product in, I always love starting off with the brows. So I'm going to start off by using MAC Technical Brow Pencil in the shade Lingering. So I'm going to be going underneath her brows with small strokes, shading in any sparse areas that she has in her brows, giving her a little bit more of a shape and giving her that striking arch. I always like to set my brows. So to set my brows in place, I like to go over with Anastasia Dip Brows and Pomade in the shade Soft Brown for a more defined full brow. I'm using this product with my MAC 266 angled brush. Now, starting off with the eyes, I'm gonna be running my MAC 252 large shader brush with the Pro Longwear paint pot and the shade Soft Ochre. I'm going to be applying this all over the lid. This product is amazing. It's crease proof, it's smudge proof, it's long wearing, and it's waterproof. So what you want to do is, this product dries down pretty fast, so you want to make sure you blend it all evenly throughout the eye, and this locks down the shadow. So if you're having any problems with your eyeshadow creasing or smearing, this is the way to go. Moving on to the eyes. I'm using a fluffy blending brush, and the one that I'm using is the 217 by MAC. And with this, I'm going to be using the Forest Green Shadow. This shadow is from the Morphe palette 35B, and I'm going to be going right into the socket of her crease. I'm going to be blending that back and forth in windshield wiper motion, so that gives you more of that makeup artist blend. When I'm doing makeup, I like to build my makeups in layers. That creates more of like that flawless application. So let's say layer number one can be very soft, layer number two can be a little bit more dramatic, and layer number three can just be on the corner of the eyes. That's a mistake that I see on people when they're doing their eye makeup. They just try to do it all at once. To add dimension, I love using smaller brushes. It gives you more of that precision that I'm looking for. So to create that, I'm gonna be using MAC 288 mini shader brush and the eyeshadow by Kiko and the number 213. This eyeshadow is really beautiful. As I'm applying the shade, I'm gonna be using the first brush I used to blend, and that was the my 217, just to soften any edges. And I'm gonna be doing circular motions as well. Moving on to the next, in dabbing motions, I'm gonna pack on the shade 2001 Greyhound. That was, I believe, from the Simpsons collection. And I'm gonna be applying that onto the lid. So by doing that motion, that's gonna help me build more intensity of the color that I want to achieve. I love a little highlight underneath the brow, so I'm gonna be using Nylon. Nylon is a frost finish. It's very, very highly pigmented, so with a light layer underneath with a flat brush goes a long way. In the inner portion of her eyes, I'm going to be going in with the Whisper pigment. This was from a holiday collection, I believe from last year, and I'm going to be using also a flat brush, and that is going to create more of a light bulb effect where it brightens up and opens up the area. So I'm going to be using my current obsession, which is MAC Into the Well color eyeshadow. The color is called Beg For It. This is the bomb.com. The pigmentation is so rich and it's so dark. I'm just obsessed with it. Going slightly above Kiko's 213 in dabbing motions, I'll be applying this shade only in the outer corner of the eye. To apply eyeliner, I like using my MAC 210 brush and Inglot's number 77 gel liner. Starting in the center of the lid, doing long strokes, getting really close to the lash line. To make these eyes look more sultry, Going back to the lower lash line, I'll be using MAC's 239 brush and Morphe's green eyeshadow. Running the brush underneath her lash line, going as close as you possibly can, blending and blurring the shade to complete the smoky eye. Once you've completed that, I'll be adding a tad bit of Beg For It with my 288 brush right on top. Adding MAC's Kohl pencil in the color Feline on the waterline. Continuing on to the face, I'll be working with Makeup's Forever HD Foundation Stick in the shade 120th, just around the outside perimeter of her face, and inside the perimeter of her face, I'll be placing a lighter shade, number 117, in the center and in the T-zone area. Using my 132 Duo Fiber Brush, I'll be diffusing and blending both shades simultaneously together to make sure that the product is really blended and diffused. I'm going to be playing with the architectural shape of her face by contouring with Anastasia Beverly Hills Cream Contour in Java. To apply this product, I'll be using the top of her ear as a guide to know where to start my contour. Contouring the crown of the forehead and going back to the cheekbone, also connecting that to the jawline and buffing that into the neck area for nice fluidity to the contour. And that's also going to mimic the natural shadow of her face. So to blend this product, I'll be using my MAC's 109 contour brush for the perfect blend, blurring any lines that create more of that seamless contour. Next, I'll be creating a triangle underneath her eye, and this is going to add an extra light beam just to accentuate her cheekbones. Setting the highlighted areas, I'll be applying the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder with my Beauty Blender to avoid any creasing. Using my favorite contour brush, number 168 by MAC, with Makeup's Forever Sculpting Contour Kit to set the contour areas while giving her a nice tan and making it look like real skin. To deposit fresh color back into her face, I'll be buffing MAC's Warm Light Limited Blush into the apples of her cheeks. On the high points of the face, I'll be placing Anastasia's Beverly Hills So Hollywood to awaken the skin and just to deliver a beautiful glow. And now finishing off with the lips, I'll be using MAC's Subculture Lip Liner just to give her lips a little bit more of a definition. On top, I'll be placing Anastasia Beverly Hills Pure Hollywood Liquid Lipstick and my favorite of all times, MAC's Huggable Gloss in the color Sweet Persuasion. To complete this glamorous smoky green eye, I'll be applying Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. Starting at the root, coating every lash with incredible length and volume, and just feathering any excess shadow left on the lash. Adding Stelazzi's Natural Lashes number 939 for an instant full lash. And to lock down her makeup, I'll be using Skindinavia's setting spray for a flawless finish. And that, guys, concludes this makeup tutorial. Thank you so much for tuning in. For a full list of the products used or mentioned, go to my description box down below. If you enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I would love to hear your feedback. You can also catch me on my other social media platforms such as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat at Aravany. Thank you for watching. Until next time.